We're asked to draw the graph of the compound inequality x greater than negative 2 and x less than or equal to 6. We're also asked to describe the set using interval notation. This is called a compound inequality, and there are two types of compound inequalities. One uses the word and one uses the word or. When two inequalities are joined by the word and, the solution of the compound inequality occurs when both inequalities are true at the same time. It is the overlap or intersection of the solutions for each inequality. When the two inequalities are joined by the word or, the solution of the compound inequality occurs when either of the inequalities is true. The solution is the combination or union of the two individual solutions. So because we have the word and, we're looking for the intersection of these two intervals. Let's begin by graphing both intervals on the same number line. So we first graph x greater than negative 2. Negative 2 is not in this interval, and therefore we have an open circle or open point on negative 2. And because it's x greater than negative 2, we have an arrow to the right where values are greater than negative 2. And to the right, we know we're approaching positive infinity. And now we graph x less than or equal to 6. Notice 6 is in this interval, and therefore we have a closed circle or closed point on positive 6. And because it's x less than or equal to 6, we have an arrow to the left where values are less than 6. And to the left, we approach negative infinity. Now to determine our solution, we need to interpret this graph. Because we have the word and, we're looking for the intersection of these two intervals, which would be the interval where the values are graphed twice. Notice how the values that are graphed twice, or the intersection, are all the values between negative 2 and positive 6, not including negative 2, but including positive 6. This means the graph of our solution would have an open circle on negative 2, a closed circle or closed point on positive 6, and we graph all the values between. So this is the graph of our solution, which now we want to express using interval notation. This is the interval from negative 2 to 6, so we have negative 2 comma 6. The interval does not include negative 2, so we have a rounded parenthesis to the left of negative 2. The interval does include 6, so we have a square bracket to the right of 6. Now I also want to mention, if we can express this interval using inequalities, it looks a little bit different than the way it's expressed as given. We can also express this interval as x greater than negative 2 and less than or equal to positive 6. This interval using inequalities is the same interval as the given interval, x greater than negative 2 and x less than or equal to 6. Let's look at a second example. We have the same directions. We want to find the interval described by x less than or equal to negative 4 and x greater than 0. So we first graph x less than or equal to negative 4. Negative 4 is in the interval, so we have a closed circle or closed point on negative 4. And because it's x less than or equal to negative 4, arrow to the left, approaching negative infinity. And now we graph x greater than 0. 0 is not in the interval, so we have an open circle or open point on 0. If x is greater than 0, so we have an arrow to the right, where values are greater than 0. And to the right, we approach positive infinity. And now we interpret this graph based upon the fact that we have an and compound inequality, and therefore we're looking for the intersection of these two intervals. Well, notice how these two intervals do not intersect. There are no values on the number line graphed twice, and therefore this indicates there is no solution to the compound inequality, which means the graph of our solution would be this number line with nothing graphed on it, and we say no solution. Some sources may also say the solution does not exist and therefore use the abbreviation DNE. I hope you found this helpful.